Good morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to morning prayer.
Stand together for what you believe. Work for what must be done. Love each other in all that you do. My brothers, spread it everywhere. Make the world know right from wrong. Help the world to care. Stand together for what you believe. Work for what must be done. Love each other in all.
Let us begin. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Let us pray. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Divinity. O come, let us sing out to the Lord. Let us shout in triumph to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his face with thanksgiving and cry out to him joyfully in psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great king above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the peaks of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, and he made it. His hands molded dry land. Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he himself is our God. We are his people, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. If only you would hear his voice today, for he comes. He comes to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Psalms appointed for today are Psalms 30 and 32. Psalms 30 and 32.
Psalm 30. I will exalt you, O Lord, because you have lifted me up and have not let my enemies triumph over me.
O Lord, my God, I cried out to you, and you restored me to health.
You brought me up, O Lord, from the dead. You restored my life as I was going down to the grave.
Sing to the Lord, you servants of his. Give thanks for the remembrance of his holiness.
For his wrath endures but the twinkling of an eye, his favor for a lifetime.
Weeping may spend the night, but joy comes in the morning.
While I felt secure, I said, I shall never be disturbed. You, Lord, with your favor, made me as strong as the mountains.
Then you hid your face, and I was filled with fear.
I cried to you, O Lord. I pleaded with the Lord, saying,
what profit is there in my blood if I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you or declare your faithfulness?
Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. O Lord, be my helper.
You have turned my wailing into dancing. You have put off my sackcloth and clothed me with joy.
Therefore, my heart sings to you without ceasing. O Lord my God, I will give you thanks forever.
Psalm 32. Happy are they whose transgressions are forgiven and whose sin is put away.
Happy are they to whom the Lord imputes no guilt and in whose spirit there is no guile.
While I held my tongue, my bones withered away because of my groaning all day long.
For your hand was heavy upon me day and night. My moisture was dried up as in the heat of summer.
Then I acknowledged my sin to you and did not conceal my guilt.
I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord. Then you forgave me the guilt of my sin.
Therefore, all the faithful will make their prayers to you in the time of trouble. When the great waters overflow, they shall not reach them.
You are my hiding place. You preserve me from trouble. You surround me with shouts of deliverance.
I will instruct you and teach you in the way that you should go. I will guide you with my eyes.
Do not be like horse or mule, which have no understanding, which must be fitted with bit and bridle, or else they will not stay near you.
Great are the tribulations of the wicked, but mercy embraces those who trust in the Lord.
Be glad, you righteous, and rejoice in the Lord. Shout for joy, all who are true of heart.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Pray the canticle, Jesus Savior. Jesus Savior of the world, come to us in your mercy. We look to you to save and help us. By your cross and your life laid down, you set your people free. We look to you to save and help us. When they were ready to perish, you saved your disciples. We look to you to come to our help. In the greatness of your mercy, loose us from our chains. Forgive the sins of all your people. Make yourself known as our Savior and mighty deliverer. Save and help us that we may praise you. Come now and dwell with us, Lord Christ Jesus. Hear our prayer and be with us always. And when you come in your glory, make us to be one with you and to share the life of your kingdom.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the Gospel according to John. Chapter 17, verses 20 to 26. I ask not only on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one. As you, Father, are in me and I am in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that they may become completely one, so that the world may know that you have sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. Father, I desire that those also whom you have given me may be with me where I am to see my glory, which you have given me because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you, and these know that you have sent me. I made your name known to them, and I will make it known so that the love with which you have loved me may be in them, and I in them. The Word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, Jesus prays. Jesus prays. Jesus prays for his disciples. Jesus prays for all believers. Jesus prays for unity amongst all believers. Jesus prays. Jesus prays for his disciples. He then prays for believers, all believers, to come to God, to see God's glory, and to one day meet God in that place, his kingdom, to see him in all of his fullness, not just the limited fullness, not just the limited power that he exhibited while on earth, but that all believers will come to see God in his fullness, all of his fullness. Jesus prays for unity. Unity amongst believers. If we are believers, we ought to follow Christ. His commandment is to follow him. Do as he does. Live as he lived. It means we ought to pray. It also means we have specific prayer requests to pray for each other, to pray for all believers, all. And there is an irony in the whole thing. We do not know who are believers. We do not know. And so we must assume, that everybody is a believer. And therefore, we must pray for everybody. Pray for everybody. Whether they are from a different denomination, whether they are of a different race, a different class. And when you consider it, those are the things that we put out there that causes the dissension, causes the disruption, causes the break in the unity. The Israelites, they were once together, but then the tribes separated. And I mean, throughout the journey, different things happened. People held to their own traditions and practices and caused that to separate them totally. Understand this. The separation became about, the separation was caused because they were holding to their traditions and practices rather than holding on to God, rather than focusing on God. If we have love for one another, love for God, love for one another, then we can have unity, because love binds everything. Love binds. The fact that he prays for unity is that it is an important criteria for us, an important role and job for us. We must work towards being a unit together. Together. So many things are written about unity. And as I say that, I need to pause, right? Because there's this urge to go off into the dialect or dialect and say, I don't know what really going on. But because here I looked up the word unity. All I typed was unity, expecting, maybe it's my fault, my own expectation, to see unity is a game. And I laughed. I chuckled. Because this is how we live. They've created a game and they say all what the game is about and so forth. And they call it unity. And that's fine. But when we consider how we live with each other, unity is a game. It is a game. It is something that you try and play ever so often, but you're really not interested. You may not be interested in it. You set it aside when you don't feel like it. When it holds no interest for you, you set it aside. It's a game. And that's how we treat each other. if we would move away from all the factions and fractions, not considering the color of each other's skin, but embracing one another. And considering the color of our skin is not white or black or Hispanic, you know, even in yourself, there is classism and racism. Even in your own ethnic grouping, we're still separating and segregating, whether we belong to the same denomination or not, and further causing disunity. If in our, and we could simply start in our own context, our own denomination, our own faith system, our own faith community, working together, then we can achieve that goal that God wants for all of us. Oh, how pleasant and great it is for brethren to work together. All over Scripture talks about unity. May not be the word unity, but togetherness is unity. Loving one another is unity. Love, love, love. It's not the feeling, it's the action. And if we would act in love, the love that God has for us, that He teaches us to have for one another. Just as He was chastising the Pharisees, you are focused on the when Jesus healed the man, you are focused on the law that you yourself created. You created it. That you will do what you feel to do to break that law. But here I am, healing this man, bringing him that peace and comfort that he so needed, meeting him at the point of his need. And instead of rejoicing in the fact that your brother has been healed, you are focusing on trying to catch me. You're focusing on trying to trap me. You're focusing on trying to condemn me. The breakdown, the separation. We need to work together. What does it say? More hands make light the work. What does our, you know, for Trinidad and Tobago, it is there on our coat of arms, our watchword. Together we aspire, together we achieve. Is it there for us to just watch, to look at? No, it is there to encourage us and remind us that if we would come together, we would get more things done. If we would come together, we would grow. And this is, you know, I always love the reference or the background of the ants, those little creepy crawly things that bite and crawl all over. I'm really not sure what it's been doing sometimes other than biting me. But they're living and part of the food chain, part of the ecosystem. They have their strengths individually. They do. There are ants that fly. There are those that are army ants. Those are the ones that stand guard. There are the worker ants. They go and they come and they move around and whatever else. Each having their own role. And let's not look at a movie that tries to distort the way they live. People have studied ants. But they have their own roles and functions. And nobody is trying to overstep the other. Nobody's trying to do that. None of them are trying to overstep the other. But that they are working together. So one, the scout, one goes out, and I don't understand how they move so quickly. Okay, these tiny bits, how they move so quickly. Anyway, one will go out and scout, come back, and they send that message to the rest, and the rest comes. And together, they move what they need to move. They store their food. If you see how quickly they build a home nestled in the dung inside of there, quickly, because they're working together together, bit by bit, bit by bit, dirt by dirt, clumps by clumps. They move and they create all of these thousands of tunnels that lead all over the place, making and building a home. It is very fascinating. You should look it up. Check it out. And not just look at it for, not just learning about ants, but learning about how we ought to be living with one another. Not trying to lord ourselves over one another, but doing our part with what we have, with the skills that we have been given, with the roles that we have been given, to make that space that God could dwell, to live in unity with one another, to grow God's kingdom, to grow God's people, that more persons will be saved and come to God. The prayer for believers, pray for the strength and encouragement of one another. That is also part of our role in unity. Not for the demise, but for belief in God, to live daily honoring God, strengthen their resolve in Christ, to continue to trust God because it gets harder. Sometimes it feels like it's too much. And if we would support each other, Scripture tells us where two or three are gathered, when we agree, let us agree in support of one another. Pray that our brothers and sisters who are believers will pick up their cross, will pick up their role and function daily. Pray for the strengthening of our leaders. Pray that we will continue to walk in faith in this God that loves us, and not fall into temptation or the ways of this world that try to deter us and make us feel that God does not exist. Make us feel that whatever we have been believing in will not happen because He is invisible. Pray that eyes of believers will be open and will only see God and His way and His steps, and have the courage to put their feet in His steps, to follow Him, to trust Him blindly, with confidence in His love, confidence in His power, confidence in His promises. That is how we ought to live in unity, by working together and building each other up. Pray also that we, each one of us, pray for yourself to do what God has called you to do, to let go, to reconcile all broken relationships with each other and with God, even with yourself. Pray for the strength to do these things. Pray for the know-how, how to live in unity with one another. Pray that God will show you what He wants you to do. And when He shows you, brothers and sisters, when He shows you, get up and do it. We need to pray for each other, because it is together we are better. We are better together. We are better as a community, helping each other, sharing. You know, in the early church, when they talk about, and we all know the story of Ananias and Sapphira, and they had to go, because the church is building, people are there, they're coming, and they want to be a part of it. And the rules are straightforward. Just leave everything and come. come and share so that you don't have to focus. If we will take care of each other, you don't have to focus on what to eat, you don't have to focus on where to live, because everybody was equal in the community. But you see, they had this thought, they were wavering. It's like, you know, let's go kind of halfway. So we will go and see what it is like, but let's not sell everything. We keep something back just in case this does not pan out. And so they come in, and wisdom, there is the Holy Spirit talking to them and say, talking to Moses, already alerting him as to what is happening. And he asks them plain, is this everything? Yes. What? They die. They had to go because you're hiding. You're pretending while everybody is trying to work together. When you do those kinds of things, you are now coming to bring disunity in the camp, coming to break down what is building up. You see why it is important for us to check ourselves? Why it is important for us to look at how we behave and how we act? So that we will not go against what God wants for us, but that we will work in alignment with God's will for us. Oh, how good it is, good and pleasant it is for brethren to work together. Let's strive for one faith. Let's strive for one church. Let's strive for unity in the camp, so that we will all see God in his fullness, in his glory. Pray for each other. Amen. And so we confess boldly our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made, and forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Eternal God and Father, by whose power we are created and by whose love we are redeemed, guide and strengthen us by your Spirit, that we may give ourselves to your service and live this day in love for you and one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. O God, the lover of unity and the author of peace, to know you is eternal life, to serve you as perfect freedom. Defend us, your servants, from all assaults of the enemy, that we may trust in your defense and not fear the power of any adversary. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite us to offer our own petitions at this time. Let us pray for unity in the church. O God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, our only Savior, the Prince of Peace, give us grace seriously to lay to heart the great dangers we are in by our unhappy divisions. Take away all hatred and prejudice, and whatever else may hinder us from godly union and concord, that as there is but one body and spirit, one hope of our calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of us all, so may we be all of one heart and of one soul, united in one holy bond of truth and peace, of faith and charity, and may with one mind and one mouth glorify you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do have a wonderful week, everyone. And I continue to pray for all of you and all of us who are on this Lenten journey. Pray for God's strength to keep us from all temptation, as well as to give up all of this world that this world has to offer and embrace God and His way and His truth. Take care.